The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... Come in. Welcome. I'm E.G. Marshall. I have a very odd subject I'd like to talk over with you. It's been perplexing philosophers for centuries. What is really real? Now, don't laugh. I'm serious. Look, if a tree falls in a forest and nobody's around to hear it fall, has it made a sound? Must someone hear a sound to make it real? If you see something, does that make it real? Yes? Then what about a mirage? If you think something, does that make it real? What is reality? That question was asked 100 years ago in a third-rate European circus, and I wonder whether you will agree with the answer they found.
Can I help you with your costume, Francesca?
No, don't touch me.
But I... Why are you talking like this, Francesca? You never sound... You are Francesca.
No, I'm Simone.
Oh, I can never tell you two apart.
Do you want me to give you fair warning?
Why can't we be civil to each other, Simone?
Because I hate you just as much as my sister loves you. And you hate me.
I don't hate you.
But you love Francesca.
Yes, I think I do.
Don't you know that love and hate can be twin sisters, like Francesca and me?
No, I don't believe it. I can't believe it. Only one can be real.
Our mystery drama, 2 + 2 = death, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Alfred Bester and stars William Redfield and Marion Seldes. It is sponsored in part by Buick Motor Division and Allied Van Lines. I'll be back shortly with Act One. No matter how third-rate it is, you have to feel sorry for Mario's one-ring circus this cold afternoon in Zurich. One of their stars died on stage in the middle of his performance. He was Gerard the Great. The unbelievable, the miraculous, the incredible mechanical man. And with him, the illusion died. Now Gerard is being buried in an obscure graveyard in Zurich, mourned by the clowns and freaks and dancers of the company who decorate the tombstone with mementos, props, bits of costume and makeup, all the real things that help create illusion. A young man, well-dressed, carrying a travel bag, joins the strange ceremony.
Aha! You must be Peter, the great Gerard's son. I recognize you even after all these years. You are Gerard's image, Peter. Welcome on this sad occasion.
I took the first train from Paris.
You remember me?
I remember nothing.
But you must remember me.
No.
Ah, I understand. You think if you forget, it will go away. It will never have happened. But I am Mario. Mario Milan. When you were a piccolino, so high, I taught you what little your father forgot. The tightrope, the slack wire, the left foot take. You were my little genius, my wunderkind.
Yes, Mario, of course. I see I came too late for the funeral.
Well, you couldn't help yourself, Peter. It was all over in a moment. The heart collapsed.
You couldn't wait a day for me?
My dear boy, we play Innsbruck Monday. These are your colleagues. Come and meet them.
My colleagues?
Ladies and gentlemen of the company, this is Gerard's son, Peter. Many years ago, a member of our troupe.
No, never.
then retired to become a civilian. He entered the unreal world of business and education to become an engineer.
Not an engineer, an architect.
He designed the Eiffel Tower, also the Leaning Tower and the Tower of Babel, for which he was awarded a gold medal engraved in all languages.
Ah, clown.
What, do you want us to cry? We love Gerard, your father.
I never knew him.
It was your misfortune. When I lost Gerard, I lost a little of my hold on life. Shall we return to the city? Matinee today. Come with me, Peter.
No, Mario. I'll stay a moment.
Of course. Come to your father's caravan when you are finished with grief. But don't take too long. First overture at 3:00.
What?
Why, have you forgotten? Overture and beginners, please. 3:00. Arrivederci.
I'm sorry.
What?
Excuse me. I said, I'm sorry about your father.
What are you waiting for?
It's not good to be alone with the dead.
I need no one, thank you.
My name is Francesca. I dance in the ballet. And I helped your father with the illusion. I brought him to life.
Huh. You brought him to life.
I wound him up with this key.
Oh, yes. Yes, I remember that. Then he came out of the toy box.
I loved your father, too.
You and Mario.
Everybody loved him. He was the only gentle man I ever knew.
My father, gentle?
There was never any violence in him. He was all kindness.
What? Gerard, do you believe that?
I know it.
It was his greatest illusion.
You sound as though you hate him.
He deserted my mother and me. How should I feel?
Is that why she didn't come here?
No. She died 3 years ago.
Excuse me. Gerard always said your mother took you and ran away from him.
He was a fraud, like the rest of you.
Why are you so angry with us?
If you could just stop acting for one moment.
But I'm not acting.
No? When are you never? All of you. Mario Milan clowning at the grave, and you.
Oh.
Are those supposed to be real tears?
What? I didn't know there were tears.
All make-believe. Pretend, unreal. A scene must be played. Cue the tears, and the tears come on cue. Crocodile.
Well, they say you can always tell real tears from crocodile tears because they burn when you touch them. So try mine.
My dear friend...
Francesca.
Oh.
Give me your hand. Try, my dear. Your hand is frozen. Oh, you're so cold and angry. That means you're lonely. Of course, that's why you're hating everything.
I never hated anything in my life.
Until you came here. And you saw how lonely you were for your father. And us.
Please... Francesca.
Let me warm your other hand. Give it to me. Huh. You know, you said, please, Francesca, exactly like your father. You are so much like him. Will that make you my stepbrother?
Or your step-lover?
You said that to hurt me, didn't you? I've never had a lover.
I'm sorry, Francesca. I don't know what's got into me. This crazy world of illusion. You're all so strange, and you're the strangest. May I have my hand back, please?
You haven't tried my tears yet.
They've burned me already.
Well, we better get back to the... Oh, wait, I almost forgot. Have you a keepsake for your father? Something to put on his grave?
How can I? He gave me nothing.
Then give him this. It's the key I used to bring him to life.
Oh, his last illusion.
Who are you? What are you doing in Gerard's caravan?
What?
Don't you dare touch anything.
But I...
Is this a joke?
Get out. Do I have to call the stagehands? Get out. And I'll search you before you leave.
But I belong here. You know that. This caravan's mine now.
Since when?
Unless my father never owned it.
Your father? Then you are Peter Gerard?
This is altogether beyond me. Look, have I done anything to make you act this way?
How could you possibly?
Then what's happened? Is this revenge? I thought we were going to be friends.
Since when?
Why? I give up. All right, it's a joke. A circus sort of joke on outsiders like me. But it isn't funny. Not to me. It's turning my hands cold again. Feel.
Don't touch me.
Dear heaven, what now?
Didn't your father tell you about me?
I told you I never knew my father. What was he supposed to tell me about you?
That this was my caravan, too.
You and my father? But you said...
Yes, I said...
Atodikas, second overture has started.
I'll move my things out after the matinee.
Oh.
Aha. Oh, very interesting girl.
Yes, fantastic. She took me for a thief.
So?
She caught me going through my father's things.
What were you looking for?
Money. My mother said he promised me.
Aha. To start that engineering office of your own, huh?
Architect.
Oh, you pardon.
I have a friend in Paris, Marcel Roger, a brilliant designer. We're going into business together.
And it will cost you 5,000. Gerard told me often, and with pride. What's the time? Time I had a look around backstage. The manager must see everything. You're coming.
Why not? There's nothing for me here. I might as well look at the animals.
You must not hate us this much, Peter.
I don't suppose my father managed to save the 5,000.
But of course he did. Gerard was man of his word.
He did? Do you know where it is?
Well, naturally. He loaned it to me.
To you?
To our company. I explained. We had 3 very bad months. We would have folded. Your father saved us.
But my office...
The money will be repaid. We now show a profit again. Give me 3 months and...
3 months? What am I to do in the meantime?
Peter, I will tell you how you can spend your 3 months.
Yes?
With us. You will close the first act.
What?
Starting next Monday at Innsbruck.
You're mad.
Yes, I admit it. To trust a civilian with the finale of the first half is insanity. But then I remember, Gerard taught the boy the act, detail by detail. He will remember. He has talent.
You want me to do the mechanical man illusion?
It's the only act that can close the first half. I've tried all the others, and I know only the great illusion will do.
Mario, don't be ridiculous. I'm an architect.
But you began life as an artist. If you do not help us, you may never get your money. There must be an act to close the first half.
Hire an act.
Where will I find the time and the money? What will we do in the meantime?
Oh, damn it, Mario.
Help me, please, for 3 months. Then you can go back to Paris with your money. It will be easy. 2 whole days to remember and rehearse before we open. Francesca will help, and I, too. Now, go back to the caravan and look over your costume.
No, absolutely not. Find another animal.
Peter, Mario just told me. I think it's wonderful. I'm so excited.
Francesca?
I have a little time now so we could start going through the act with you. What's the matter? You're not nervous, are you?
No. Just flabbergasted.
Why? Mario says you know the act. I think you'll be even greater than... What is the matter with you?
I meet you for the first time, and you're adorable. A half hour later, you burst into this caravan and behave like a devil. Now here you are, an angel again.
But I haven't been in here with you.
Not 20 minutes ago, calling me a thief and a ghoul and saying foul things about yourself
Ray
and my
Ray
father,
Ray,
I...
Me? Me?
Yes, you. In that same costume, wearing that same face.
Oh, I'm sorry. Well, it must have been Simone.
Who?
My sister, Simone. We both dance in the ballet. You know, 12 ballerinas. 12.
Your sister, you... You mean twins?
Of course. It happens all the time with strangers.
Oh, how can twin sisters be so different?
Well, later, later. Now, rehearsal first. And we've got to find out how much of the illusion you remember.
Everything. That's what I was running away from.
Well, we'll start with after I open the toy box. Oh.
What's the matter?
We'll need a new key for the act. I'll have to go and tell the prop man.
Here's the old key, Francesca.
You didn't put it on your father's grave?
No. I kept it. I wanted something from my father. Take the key, Francesca. Wind me up into a wonderful illusion.
So here we have the equation. Two girls named Francesca and Simone, identical twins, and two men, Peter Gerard, architect, and Peter the Great, the miraculous mechanical man. 2 plus 2. And they add up to death. How? Perhaps the arithmetic of the second act will tell us. And so the deadly arithmetic of illusion continues in the form of Peter the Great, the miraculous mechanical man in Mario's giant variety show and one-ring circus. 1 week only in Innsbruck, 2 weeks in Verona, 10 days only in Lausanne, final week in Nancy.
Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to present the unbelievable, the miraculous, the incredible mechanical man, Peter the Great. Ah, what have we here, ladies and gentlemen? It is the prettiest member of our giant corps de ballet wheeling in a gift box so beautifully tied with a ribbon. Is this a gift for me, Francesca?
No, Mario. It is a gift for our kind audience.
Ah, our pretty Francesca opens the box. And what do we see inside? What is her gift to you? I tremble with suspense, ladies and gentlemen. Good heavens! It is a giant toy! It is Peter, the mechanical man!
I have this magic key, Mario. Peter must be wound up!
Ah, ha, 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 bravo, bravo. Peter has come to life. The mechanical man is alive. See, ladies and gentlemen, how naturally he bows to you and to the lovely Francesca.
It's going very well.
What are you doing backstage?
Who... I'm Marcel Roget, Peter's friend from Paris. Perhaps he has mentioned me?
No, excuse me, I must go on again.
Don't you ever relax?
I'm working.
You were splendid, Peter, as usual. Here is a surprise for you. I permitted him to wait backstage.
Marcel, what the devil are you doing here?
If you'll excuse me.
Certainly, sir. Thank you. It's been an experience waiting back here. Peter, fantastic.
Yes, I suppose it is.
When I got your letter about the delay, I had to come and see for myself.
See what?
A real reason for the delay. 12 ballerinas. 12, yes?
No. What are you really doing here, Marcel? You didn't make a special trip.
I had a stopover between trains. Peter, you must come back to Paris.
There's no need until we can afford to take the office. I explained in my letter.
There's every need. There are people to be met and cultivated who can become clients.
You can do that.
I haven't the flair. We agreed that you'd be the contact man. This is no life for you.
All right, Marcel. When does your train leave?
In an hour.
And you'd better not miss it.
Huh?
I'll come to Paris as soon as I've collected my money.
Which is it? Does this bear costume shrink, or have I gained 10 kilos?
I think it is the kilos, Mario. Your bicycle is having its problems, too.
What a disgrace for an impresario to ride a bicycle dressed as a bear.
With a red ribbon around his neck, allow me.
Yeah, but we all must do everything, you too. Please, the ballet, have the girls are not fully buttoned. Ah, I hear my cue.
Are you buttoned, Francesca? Can I help? Will a kiss help?
I'm buttoned.
Meet you right after. Francesca?
Simone.
I take back the kiss.
It was not received.
I can never tell you two apart.
Shall I give warning?
Why can't we be civil to each other, Simone?
Where are you meeting, Francesca? Up in the fly gallery, as usual?
Ah. Have we been that obvious?
Transparent.
The fly gallery is the only private place we can find. High over the stage.
Private? For what? What do you talk about there, up above the stage? Yourself?
And Francesca.
And me? Simone.
Now and then. I wonder how you can be so like her on the outside and so different within.
Oh, you fool. What do you think my saintly sister is hiding from you? Every woman is like me inside.
No, Simone.
You want Francesca to love you? She despises you as I do. She's only nice to you to help Mario.
You're lying, Simone. And you lied about my father, too. Why do you always attack me?
You don't like that, huh? You want women to be magical illusions. But some of us are too honest.
You're not being honest. You're being vicious.
Then go up to the fly gallery and wait for her. She's all magic now. But when you meet the real woman behind it, will you be able to love her, Peter? The great illusionist.
Packed house tonight, Peter. Very good. I think I will report on finances to you.
Yes?
After I check the box office, I come to your caravan. Or are you up in the gallery tonight?
Oh, does everybody know?
No, not everybody. You have been wonderfully discreet, but as manager, I must know everything and say nothing. It will be interesting to see what happens.
What should happen?
You don't find Francesca interesting?
Mario, how can Francesca and Simone be sisters? They're so incredibly different.
The patineur is about to begin, and we need the snow. Since you are for the fly gallery, Peter, you will oblige by sprinkling the skaters. The snow is in a brown paper bag waiting on the scaffold. Sometimes I wonder whether all life is waiting in a brown paper bag.
Francesca.
I'm coming. Stairs are harder than the dancing.
Oh.
They take my breath. Hello.
It is Francesca.
Of course. What's the matter?
I had an accident.
What? An accident? Oh, let me help you sprinkle the snow.
Yes.
What accident? How? When?
I kissed Simone by mistake. Now, don't laugh. I'd like a guarantee of identity, please.
You could kiss me and see.
Huh?
No. Wait, I've got better proof. See?
Huh? The key. What are you doing with that?
Oh, I keep it handy. Just in case you need winding up.
Well, I suppose the rest of the company thinks I do. Simone said I avoid everybody.
Oh, honestly? She's impossible.
But it's true, isn't it?
You're getting to like us. More and more.
It's still so strange. I'm being pulled two ways. Part of me loves this life, and part of me... Oh, why do you always start me talking about myself?
Because I want to know all about you.
Simone says I talk about myself too much.
Oh, never listen to Simone. She read a book once about women being slaves, and she never got over it. Come. What were you going to tell me, Peter?
Francesca, in Paris, I know who I am and who everybody is. But here in Mario's show...
Are we so different?
Well, look at this stuff we're sprinkling... Is it real snow?
If I want it to be.
Ah, that's the difference between us. I never know where I stand with you people. I never know if something is real or you're just pretending it's real.
Well, anything's real, if you believe it. Show's over.
Francesca, do you despise me? Simone said...
Oh, never listen to her, Peter.
Have you been kind to me just as a favor to Mario?
How could you possibly think that?
Simone said...
Listen, you must be patient with her. She's afraid.
Of me?
No, of losing me. She needs me. She wants me to need her.
I need you, Francesca.
You don't mean that.
I do. I'm afraid to say it. Help me, Francesca.
You need the key, Peter. Here. Against your heart.
Come to me. Oh.
Say it.
I love you.
It took you long enough.
I ran down.
And what would happen if I lost the key?
I'd run down forever.
I'll never part with it.
Nor I.
Peter!
It's Mario.
He knows we're up here.
Come down from the gallery.
There's nobody up here.
Come to the stage, Peter. I want to talk to you.
You can't ask a man to leave heaven.
What is it like up there in heaven?
All magic.
Come down to earth for a moment.
You took your time getting here, you know. Oh, alas, you look like angels recently arrived from heaven.
And you look like the devil.
It's all this snow. I can't stand cold weather. Here, Peter, a gift from the box office.
Huh? What gift?
Your 5,000. Paid in full.
You don't mean 3 months have passed already?
2 months, 2 weeks, and 4 days. Now you can go back to Paris and build your bridges.
Well, what about closing the first half?
I have some possibilities.
I can't desert you.
Will you go back to Paris?
Francesca, do you want me to go?
Francesca has nothing to do with it. I ask again, will you return to Paris and a safe life? This is your last chance.
I can leave any time.
You cannot. The poison is seeping into your soul. In another month, it will be too late.
Poison?
He means me.
Francesca, be quiet. Peter, will you go back to sanity and reality now or never?
Francesca... I'm not me anymore. I'm part of us. We add up to more. Is it the same with you?
Yes.
Mario, invest the money in the company for us. All except 100. I want you to spend that.
On what?
A dinner for the company. A wedding dinner.
Whose?
Ours.
Francesca, you want to marry him?
Yes.
And does Simone?
What about Simone?
Does she want this marriage? Does Peter know he will have to live with Simone, too?
No, she'll leave. She'll never come back.
Can you promise?
I swear it, Mario.
What is all this? Family squabbles? I can learn to get along with Simone.
I don't want you to, Peter. I don't want to share you with her. She'll leave the company. I know it, Mario. I swear it.
You have honor, Francesca. I take your word. So, a kiss for a bride-to-be, a handshake for the groom-to-be. You have a hand of iron, Peter. The impresario blesses you. Go, go, go. Be married.
Oh, Mario,
Mario.
Ciao. Arrivederci.
Thank you. Find.
Simone, can you hear me? I know you are listening somewhere. I know you heard her. In heaven's name, Simone, go. Go forever.
Francesca once told Peter that when she and her twin sister Simone were children and used to play make-believe, their mother would say, "Why can't you be yourselves?" And they would answer, "We want to be all ourselves." And their mother always replied, "Only one self to a person." Is that true? Must all of us be limited to one self? Or can we be many people? And what happens if we are? What do all the different selves add up to in Act 3? It was an amusing custom 100 years ago to serenade newlyweds with a chivalry, a noisy concert of banging pots and pans, shouts, whistles, anything that would make a racket. And the members of Mario's little circus are outside Peter's caravan, serenading the brand new Mr. and Mrs. Peter Gerard.
ladies and gentlemen, please, ladies and gentlemen, we thank you. We thank you for the concert. We also thank you for refraining from the bad jokes and platitudes customary at this time. Now, I remind you that we have a performance this evening at 9 o'clock and that a champagne supper will be served on stage immediately after the show. So, do you remember the first words we heard when we were apprentices in variety? It was, "Overture and beginners, please. Thank you for the overture. Now, give the beginners a chance." Oh, I got rid of them, Francesca. 3 hours to curtain time. We can relax and rest. A kiss for the groom? Well, thank you, but take off your veil, darling. I'm being kissed through a colander. You hardly spoke a word to me all afternoon. That's not like the real you.
Isn't it?
Well, don't be cryptic. That isn't like you. What's the matter?
Nothing.
You don't have to be frightened of love, darling.
I wasn't with your father. Why should I be with you?
Francesca?
Simon.
Oh, no. No, this is a practical joke. Yes, they put you up to it as a... Please, don't, Francesca.
Simon.
Oh, stop it. Please, dearest, don't tease. Not now. Show me the key.
What key?
You remember, in the gallery... You said it was a test to tell you apart. You would always carry it so I would know it was you. The key that winds the mechanical man. You're Francesca. I can't be mistaken.
Even that time you kissed me.
I've been tricked. She couldn't.
How tricked? You can't tell us apart. What's the difference?
Tricked by both of you.
You wanted her. You'll have to take both of us now. Peter and Francesca. Peter and Simone.
No. Let me out of here.
Simon, you swore you'd get out of my life. You promised I'd never see you again.
And you believe me, Francesca. You are so deliciously naive. You'll believe anything.
Please, Simon, don't do this to us. Keep your promise. It's not too late. Go away.
And leave you two to live happily ever after. What a sweet dream. No, Francesca, you go away. I've got your man. Don't try to fight me.
I'll tell him, Simon. I'll tell him everything about you and me. And he'll drive you out.
If he believes you. If he understands you. Could anybody understand? Stand and believe.
You devil. You devil.
Peter, are you up in the gallery?
I'm up in hell.
Oh, I hope you'd be here. I looked everywhere else first. What's that you've got?
Souvenir of the box office. The cashier's pistol.
Oh, no.
You sound like Francesca. Are you?
I brought the key. See?
You should have brought the music box. The miraculous mechanical man blows his brains out to music. If he can't pull the trigger, wind him up.
It's her fault. Simone broke her word. She promised she'd go away. She swore we'd never see her again.
But she didn't. Why?
Because I love you and she hates it.
How did she do it?
She tricked me. Tricked both of us. She... Oh. What difference does it make? It's done.
Francesca, look at me. There's got to be a way out of this. We've got to help each other. You've been concealing something. Tell me the truth about Simone.
You know her. My twin. She's a part of me.
Oh, Peter, there's no way out of this.
I can't believe that.
You're saddled with Simon for the rest of your life.
No.
We can't help each other.
We've got to, Francesca, or she'll destroy us.
She has already. You belong to Simone, Peter.
She can't hold me. Give me a chance to work something out. I'll talk to Simone. Will you wait here for me?
She won't listen.
Just let me try. Will you wait here?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
I won't fail.
Ecco, the groom. Four cases of champagne. There was not room enough in my caravan to store all the bottles, so I took the liberty of using yours.
Where's Simone?
Gone forever, no?
She wasn't here when you came in?
No.
Mario, that 5,000. I need it in cash.
It's your money.
I want it now, as soon as possible.
Am I permitted to ask for what?
No.
So be it. One must always obey the creditor. It is in the box office. I will get it. Ah, the bride at last, with her luggage.
Hello, Mario. I'm moving in.
And I am moving out.
It's all yours, Simone. I also am moving out.
I love Paris.
Don't try to follow me.
I won't have to try. It will be easy.
Simone, I don't know what kind of hold you have over Francesca. I don't know what you want to do to me. But if you want to humble me, I'm begging. Please, don't hurt us.
You crawl like your father.
Damn you! All right. All right, listen. Mario's bringing my money over. 5,000. It's yours if you'll let us go.
You can't buy me out.
You haven't got me.
I've got what Francesca wanted.
I won't go near you. I'll never touch you.
Am I so hideous? You didn't think that the time you kissed me by mistake.
Shut up.
How many other times did you make the same mistake? Up in the gallery, in other places. Did you ever stop to think about that?
It never happened again.
Yes, you need Francesca. For that.
For what?
For lust. Oh, you call it love. Go right ahead. Francesca is willing, and I am an understanding wife. Francesca is always willing. She's all magic and illusion for every man. Your father was only one of them. Your father...
Damn you! Damn you!
Peter, no! Peter! No! Please! The key!
What?
The key!
Simone!
Francesca!
No! Simone! You're Simone!
Francesca!
You understand that everything you have told me is evidence and must be sworn to. Now, you have no idea why he killed her.
None that you could understand, Inspector Feldman.
No motive to suggest money, jealousy, deceit?
Yes. He was deceived. But only by himself.
How do you mean? Was there another man?
There was another woman, Inspector, but only in both their imaginations.
Huh?
She was an illusion of both.
That is not proper evidence. Now, this clock key. Can you explain why it was found in the hand of the deceased?
But I have told you. It was the prop. In the illusion act, along with the music box, she wound him up with that key. He came to life.
Yes, the mechanical man. But that was on the stage.
Oui.
Then why was it found in this caravan, in her hand?
I don't know.
I ask you again, where is the accused?
I don't know.
He will be found and arrested. What's that music?
Ah, Dieu. It is the music box that accompanies the mechanical illusion. Peter, you fool! Why did you come back?
This is the accused, carrying that music box?
Peter, be careful. This is Inspector Feldman of the police. He is...
Gerard, I arrest you on suspicion of the premeditated murder of your wife, Francesca Gerard.
Not Francesca. See... Simone.
What?
Not Francesca. Simone. I kill Simone.
What is he saying? What is he doing?
He is leaving us, Inspector.
Huh?
leaving this world and retreating into the mechanical man.
Not Francesca, Simone.
Who is this Simone? The alleged name of the deceased was Francesca.
They were one and the same. Two women in one poor, unhappy mind. She called herself by different names.
But which did he murder?
Both, Inspector. And now himself as well. You will never try him for murder, Inspector. You have lost your man, and I have lost a friend.
Francesca, wind me up.
This is his last illusion. May I have the key, please, Inspector?
This key is evidence.
What will it do? Wind up your case? The key for a moment. Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. But the mechanical man does not move. We must not disappoint our gracious audience. Francesca, wind him up to pay his respects. Ah, bravo, Francesca, bravo. Peter Gerard has come to life. The mechanical man is alive. See, ladies and gentlemen, how naturally he bows to you. And now he bows to the lovely Francesca. And now he...
The miraculous mechanical man has run down for the last time. But tell me this, if the illusion dies, must the man die too? Is reality a separate thing from dreams, or are both equal parts of the whole? Living and dying together as they did in Peter Gerard and the miraculous mechanical man, and Francesca and Simone, the two girls in one. I'll be back shortly. It's an odd story, isn't it? Peter Gerard never found the key to the mystery of the twin sisters in one, Francesca and Simone. And so he died too, because the two of him loved and hated the two of them. Two plus two equaled death. Our cast included Marion Seldes, William Redfield, Robert Dryden, and Sam Gray. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. And now, a preview of our next tale.
Ah, Mr. Morrison, on time. Good sign. Join me? And now then, in just a few moments, your client, Mr. Everett Marshall, will emerge from that building across the street. He's a tall, stout gentleman. There he is. He has that blonde girl on his arm. See them?
Yes.
They're headed for the cafe just up the block. And take this key. It will let you into the building. Walk up the stairs. Do not take the elevator to the second floor. First door on your right, you'll see the number 215. Open the door with the same key. Go into the office and wait for him.
What do you mean, wait for him?
In 5 minutes, he shall receive a telephone call and he will come back to the office. As soon as he is inside, shoot him.
Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by True Value Hardware Stores. This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.